Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Originally supposed to launch on October 31st, there is yet another delay to the Crew 3 mission. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, liftoff is now expected on Thursday 11th at 2:03 a.m. UTC or Wednesday at 10:03 p.m. EDT. NASA posted a tweet about the Crew 2 mission, which is expected to return quite soon. It says the Crew 2 mission now is targeting a return to Earth no earlier than November 8th with a splashdown off the coast of Florida. Crew Dragon Endeavour is scheduled to undock from the space station on November 7th. Crew 3 is targeted to launch no earlier than November 10th. SpaceX posted a tweet about the Crew 2 return saying targeting Monday, November 8th at approximately 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time for Dragon and the Crew 2 astronauts to depart from the space station and return to Earth. Expected to launch towards the end of November, this article about DART was posted. It says, NASA says that the Double Asteroid Redirect Test, or DART, spacecraft has arrived at SpaceX's Vandenberg Space Force Base facilities for a launch later this month. With Blue Origin protesting the HLS contract awarded to only SpaceX, this article was posted. It says, the US Court of Federal Claims ruled against Jeff Bezos's Blue Origin on Thursday in the company's lawsuit versus NASA over a lucrative astronaut lunar lander contract awarded to Elon Musk's SpaceX earlier this year. Heading over to Boca Chica, here's a view of the launch site. The orbital launch mount and tower are progressing nicely at Starbase. The launch tower chopstick catching arms are continuing to be worked on. Crews have continued to assemble the newly delivered crane at the launch site. The new crane was also seen lifting its boom. The construction of the new wide bay is continuing at pace in the yard. This Teslarati article was posted in relation to SpaceX filling the orbital tank farm with propellant. It says, less than a year after tank farm assembly began in South Texas, SpaceX has begun the painstaking process of filling Starship's first orbital launch site with thousands of tons of rocket propellant. This Raptor Center engine number 74 was delivered to the launch site. Some further Raptor engines were also seen delivered to the launch site. Here's the Ship 21 nose cone and nose cone barrel section still sitting outside. They are now preparing to lift the nose cone, I assume for stacking. This lower section for the Ship 21 prototype was moved to the mid bay. This Ship 22 nose cone barrel section was spotted and is apparently using 3.6mm steel. The B2.1 test tank is still progressing at the propellant production site. Taking a look at the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website, there are a bunch of dates coming up. There are closures for this coming week with tomorrow, Monday 8th, then Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday and Friday as well. Plus, there's also a closure scheduled for next week with Monday 15th. Like usual, we have the latest Starbase production diagram to finish this video thanks to Brendan Lewis. As always, I have to say thank you to both Mary or Boca Chica Girl and Nick Ansuini for being out there filming the Boca Chica content. Also, thank you to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.